cervical cancer is diagnosed usually in a gynecologist office. In the usual course of events where cervical cancer is diagnosed, it is usually picked up on a screening pap smear, which shows an abnormality, which then results in an examination by a gynecologist called colposcopy, where an examination in their office is performed, where with binocular microscopy, we evaluate the cervix and take directed biopsies of abnormalities that we observe. Those biopsies are then looked at by a pathologist under a microscope and then render a diagnosis as cervical dysplasia, otherwise known as the precancer or precursor lesions of cervical cancer. Sometimes, unfortunately, it's diagnosed as an invasive cervical cancer. And when we see that, the examination done by the physician is really the first and most important means of dictating how we take care of a patient. Cervical cancer is still staged basically by an exam, which is observation of the cervix, palpation or a physical exam of the cervix, meaning how big the cancer is, does it involve other adjacent structures, and then we do use some radiology such as CT scans, chest x-rays, etc., to help us guide how we take care of a patient and manage that cervical cancer. Cervical cancer, when we catch it in its early stages, stage one and some specific stage twos, we tend to use surgery for those treatments. And that can be anything from a conservative operation, meaning where the uterus is left in place, such as what's called a conization, where we excise the abnormality only on the cervix and leave the remaining cervix and leave the uterus in place. There are other options for that, which is called a trachelectomy, which is a procedure where the surgeon removes the cervix but leaves the uterus. And we use that treatment modality in patients that have invasive cervical cancer that desire future fertility. Furthermore, as we get into more advanced stages or in patients that fertility is not desired, a hysterectomy is performed. And based upon complicated issues with regards to what the stage is and the cell type, sometimes a traditional, what we call a simple hysterectomy is performed, which is one that a general OBGYN performs. However, as the stage becomes more progressed, what's called a radical hysterectomy is required, and that's performed by a gynecologic oncologist. And a radical hysterectomy is removal of the uterus and cervix and some of the adjacent structures called the perimetrium. And we also remove the lymph nodes at the time of that surgery to help dictate whether what's called adjuvant treatment is required. And for some patients, depending upon certain issues on the pathologic specimen, chemotherapy and or radiation may be required depending upon certain pathologic events. As the stage gets more advanced, such as certain stage two cancers, even certain stage one cancers require radiation, meaning that a hysterectomy is not the best first treatment. There are a lot of patients with cervical cancer that we do recommend radiation in lieu of hysterectomy because we know that the radiation is going to work as effective with less complications. And the way that radiation is prescribed for patients with cervical cancer is we do use a combination of a very small dose of chemotherapy in conjunction with radiation. The chemotherapy is not a chemotherapy where patients lose their hair. No one will really know you're receiving that chemotherapy because it's such a small dose. That small dose of chemotherapy has actually been shown to help the radiation work better, more effectively, and cure more patients. But the radiation is really the curative treatment for certain types of cervical cancer. That's administered by what's called a radiation oncologist, who's a doctor that treats cancer with radiation. And they work in concert with the GYN oncologist with the chemotherapy. That course of treatment usually takes somewhere between 7 to 8 weeks, depending upon certain pathologic and radiologic findings. There's a combination of what's called external beam radiation, where a patient lies on a table and the radiation comes just like if you were receiving an x-ray. And then there's also a portion of what we call internal or brachytherapy radiation, which is when the radiation oncologist puts the radiation right on the cervix.